Okay, so now we're here in Trento at the Porphyry Quarry. This is where the product here is made in, it's called Campata Porphyry, and it's made, the company that used to be, this land used to be owned by a prince, is that correct? Used to be owned by a prince, and so now it was privately bought, and now it produces the porphyry. Almost all the porphyry is produced on the site, from the quarrying through to the processing of the material. And here we can see the quarry. Okay, so we're right down in the depths of the quarry here. This is where the stone is blasted and then falls down, and then the material's then processed. So what is porphyry? Porphyry is actually a volcanic material. The difference is from granite. Granite typically is formed under the ground and is cooled very slowly, whereas porphyry is actually formed above the ground and is formed from the layers of the lava. And so it's actually created progressively over time with the different layers of the lava creating the different stratifications. But what's peculiar about it is that actually it's been exposed to oxygen, and that exposure to oxygen's created the crystals and also the color variation that you get between the layers. Now this originally would have been like this, but progressively over millions of years, the whole mountain or the whole shelf has actually tilted up, and that's why we have these vertical strata layers. So it's different from granite. We don't have blocks. We have more shears of material which form the layers, which has been blasted, and then those split natural stratifications come tumbling down, and then we process the stone. So this rock is coming from a blast on Friday. So you can see it's come down large pieces, and what the workmen then do is they pick the blocks and they start to crack it to see where the natural veins and how it naturally splits. Quite hard work. We also used, and it's been traditionally in Italy, they take these pebbles, and they also, apart from using them for walling for some of the large ones, they also take these pebbles and then we cut them in half. Okay, so here's an example of where the pebbles, after they've been got them, here they've been actually not sawn, but they're actually been split. And so they get this sort of rough texture, and they're laid like this, so the half of the pebble into the ground, and you have this split finish on the top, which creates a nice non-slip finish. And in fact, this has been a very, very traditional form of paving, which is traditionally used always at the entrance of churches, when they get lots of people congregating around, and makes them non-slip, and they get this very nice circular pattern. Here we're just looking at many years ago, 50 years ago, the quarry was actually down here. Part of the process with working with these quarries and with the mountains is that they've basically been revegetated over time. So as you can see down here, they're quite young, new trees. So progressively as they move back out of the quarry, the whole area has been revegetated to get back to its natural state here. And hopefully they might even be able to grow some grapes again. As you can see in the background, we have natural vineyards. So it's a very good environmental management process.
Spread out, I'm feeling you, I'm feeling you.